Welcome back to Life and Style. This is a Tistic Tuesday and we're all about that love vibe. It's Valentine's Day and happy Valentine's if no one has told you. So I'm wearing red. I just had to go the whole way. Them come by me could not just, you know, I just had to. And remember, we're giving away three amazing Dairyland gift hampers. And all you have to tell us is the different flavors of their chocolate chocolates. There you have it. So it's a chocolate artistic Tuesday thing going on. We're on visual arts and we're on photography and our set is lit. It looks really, really good. I would have confused this for paintbrush, but only that I can see a camera there. And so we've got San Africa. I say that right?
Yes.
San Africa. No, you're saying Sana. You're throwing me off. Welcome to the show, guys.
Thank
we've got
you.
Ian and Mumbor.
Yes.
Maybe you can tell us a bit about your company, how long it's been going on for, and you as the photographer, because I understand you're the photographer.
Yes.
Yeah, and how long you've been doing it, just the basics.
Okay. So San Africa is, we started last year, and yeah, we started by Ben Kiruthi and Jose Mwigai. Yes, but basically we are we have a team of photographers. Mainly we focus on weddings, engagements, corporates. Yeah, so we've been there since last year.
Since last
from
year.
From June, yeah.
Okay.
Been there in the month.
So, Mbua, what do you do for San Africa?
Well, I'm the studio / social media / marketing manager. I'm basically the link between you and our company.
Okay.
So, in case you'd want to have a studio shoot or you have a wedding coming up and you need to find out information about it, then I'm on the other line.
You're the person to talk to.
Yes.
You know, this is very, very interesting. And I like the fact that you, Ian, you brought Mumbua to the studio today because this shows how professional it is.
Yeah.
You know, you might be very good at the camera, but you're not very good at talking to people. I'm not saying you're not. Otherwise, you wouldn't be on the show. But you see, putting into the work so that you can get more, which is really interesting. So how long have you, apart from San Africa?
From South Africa,
you as a photographer, how long have you been doing it?
From as far as I can remember, like, say, 2008.
2008?
From 2008, yeah. But I've been learning. Mm-hmm. It's been a learning process.
Okay.
But professionally, since 2012.
Okay.
Yeah, 2012.
So you talked about engagements and weddings and
weddings.
How you love to do that.
Yeah.
And this is beautiful. Whose wedding is this?
This was a client that we did last year.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it looks very familiar. Do I know?
Yeah. You probably have seen it up somewhere.
I think I do. Yes. Anyway, but this is really good. And you putting it on a frame like this, is it the request of the client or is it you going out? Or is it a package that if you come to San Africa, I'm going to give you this and this and this and this and this? How does it go?
Basically, like when you give us a job to do your wedding, we can deliver it in various forms. We can, after it, we can give you a photo book, like this one, example for this one.
Take a look.
Yes.
It's pretty heavy.
Yes, yeah, but it looks nice. It's heavy.
It looks really,
really nice. Looks
and
nice.
I was talking to another photographer a few weeks back, and she was saying that the photo albums at Kitambo were really bad because someone would just pluck like a picture and go with it.
Yes.
But with this one, it's first of all, you can't walk away with it. It's very,
you can't,
very,
you can't
very
pluck a picture from it,
and long-lasting.
Yeah, and long-lasting, Also, you'd want your guests to have something nice to look at if they come to your house.
Wow, the venue. Do you get to choose where to take these shoots?
No, actually, the couple is on that decides where they want to go for their wedding photo shoot, the main wedding. So we just align ourselves with that. So all you have to do is plan the nitty-gritties of your wedding, where it's going to be, the reception, the photo session, the dinner, and we'll just be there to take care of everything.
Okay.
Yeah, in case like for the studio shoots or any other shoots, we can help you get a place where you can get awesome images.
All right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Very, very interesting. Yes. And I ask all the photographers to come on this set.
So
like what sets you apart? What would make me come to you instead
from
of,
South Africa?
You know, going to someone else?
Mm.
Yeah. I'll let the lady go first.
Definitely our affordability. Like, I think you can just open up the book and hold it up to the camera so that they can see some of the
work. There you go.
Great.
So
you see the quality photos at a very affordable price. We are very affordable.
Can you talk about what the price?
Yes, okay, definitely. For studio shoots, we just do for $350 only per
image.
For such an image.
Wow.
Yes.
Is this edited? Do they look this good?
They look that.
They did. That,
definitely.
Okay, so affordability, what else?
Yes. Mm-hmm. And quality. You get the best quality at an affordable price. Because you see, like, people want good shoots, but some prices are too high for some people to afford. And you want nice images. Totally. So we give you the best quality at an affordable price.
Okay.
Yes.
I'm looking at that thing you're holding.
Yes.
It's a cover. It looks like a weapon. It's so good. What do you call that? What is it? What is it?
Basically, here we have...
DSLR.
Yes. So we have a DSLR with a 70-200 lens, Nikon lens.
Okay.
Yes.
I'll just ignore the rest.
Yeah. And it has a battery grip. Yeah. But basically, the battery grip, it's added on to carry another battery for. Ah. So it looks big, but it's just to add another battery, yeah.
Show off.
Yes. Right.
So what's the difference? Just hold the other one.
This one.
Maybe Mumbua can help you with that.
Okay.
What's the difference between the two? And at what point do you decide to choose what lens to use and what lessons are good for outside?
Okay. Yeah. I'll start with the differences. This one is, we have a 35 Sigma Art lens on this one. But the bodies are the same.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But this one, if you want to zoom in, if you want a shot to, like, if you want to zoom in, this one would be better.
Try with my face. Say the way I'm asking for a photo.
Yeah, this one would be better if you'd want to zoom in. Yeah. The cap is on.
Yeah, I know. I know it has to be removed. Don't like to.
I wanted to see if you.
So yeah, if you want to zoom in.
If you want to zoom in, and also with the good thing about this lens, it compresses the image. As vis-a-vis this one, if I was to shoot your face with this one, I'd get the curves on your face. So this one compresses the image properly.
Okay.
Yes.
Wow.
But it depends when you want to, in which setting you want to shoot. So if in a wedding, you'd want to capture your guests in their moment. You don't want somebody in your face with this huge thing. Yeah, it will distract you.
And I'm busy saying I do.
Yeah, you're busy saying you do. Yeah. So, like, this one is a wide angle.
Okay, I think what we can do is take a picture of me with that one.
Yes.
And then with this one, and then we'll show the viewers on social media what's the difference between
the
two.
The difference, true.
How about that?
Yeah.
So I'm posing right now.
Okay.
Is it working? There you go. You're flashy, Jafanya, Ivy.
A good thing with this body, you can shoot at quite low light. You can in low light situations, yeah.
So, you know, posing and talking. Mm-hmm. There you go.
Yes.
And with
I
this
think
one
we
now,
can show it to the
camera.
We're even going to upload it.
Oh, great!
We're going to upload it.
Yeah.
But have this one? Mm-hmm. Does it have a? Just a minute.
There you go. Mumbua, you can be telling us your social media platforms. Mm-hmm. Where can people find you?
Oh, definitely.
Yes.
Well, on Facebook, it's quite simple. We are Sun Africa Studios.
Mm-hmm.
And on Instagram, at Sun Africa Studios. And Twitter, at Sun Africa Studio.
Studio, without
Studio.
The S.
Yes, yes. But if you just search for Sun Africa Studios, it's easy to find. And then we are very good with phone calls. Mm-hmm. So I can just leave our number.
No problem.
Yes, our number is 0717-354-561. Yes.
You can say that again.
Okay, great. 0717-354-561. If you're writing, 0717-354-561.
Absolutely. Oh, there you go. Ready. Yeah, now that's the flash I know.
Right.
None that pops up.
Yeah. There you go. Absolutely.
Yes. If you can see the difference, this one has more.
Yes. There's a lot of the background.
A lot of the background there.
I even showed up somewhere in there.
Yes, you did.
Yeah.
So it wasn't my photo. It's okay. And then probably physical studios, where are you guys located?
Well, we're located in Parklands. And as we didn't mention it, but we're not a walk-in kind of studio.
Okay.
You just can't show up and decide.
No way.
Yes. You have to
I feel like a photo.
You have to book an appointment because you might decide to come and we're always fully booked. So you can decide to come and we have a busy schedule. So we won't accommodate. You will give priority to the people who've booked in advance. So just call up the number and set up a time. We're just in Parklands and it's very easy to find.
Parklands.
Yeah, we actually go and pick you up. From where you
are. You serious?
Yes.
Okay, wow. This is it.
We
don't
want
to be taken to another level. So
yes,
I live in Uko Mulolongo at the river.
Mm-hmm.
And then I say, I want South Africa to come. I want a photo shoot. Mm-hmm. So you guys pick me up?
No, not necessarily picking you up from where you are, but okay. When you reach our studios. Yes. We are located just a few meters, how do I put it, along Limuru Road. Yeah. There's Aga Khan Hospital, Aga Khan University Hospital, yes. And Aga Khan Academy right okay. next to it. So just a few meters forward, if you're coming from town, there's Total Petrol Station with KFC. But watch not all these things. Yes, when you get there, you can just give us a call and we'll just
You'll
come and get
come
you.
Get
yes, and open the door for you and just let you know you're welcome.
I see why you were brought onto this show. I see. Yes. Thank you so much for coming here.
Thank you
Maybe
for having us.
Do you have a last word? Are you okay? She did everything.
Basically, if you need anything in terms of photography, South Africa is the place.
Yes.
Okay.
South Africa is the place.
Asante, South Africa is the place. KTN Life and Style is the place. So, this has been Photography on Visual Arts. So let's take a look at Creative of the Week. Today on Creative of the Week, we actually went out to Linton's. We went to them today, and we're here to find out what is fantasy look. Do you even know what it is? Probably you have it on when you go for that rugby match, for that football match. When you take your beautiful face painting, do you know that it's actually fantasy makeup? So I'm here to talk to Karline, and we're going to be talking more about that. And of course, makeup. See, my face looks really good. Yeah. Here your model setup is ready, and maybe you can introduce your makeup artists.
Yes. Well, I'm going to start with Betty.
Betty actually did my makeup today. Thank you, Betty.
Yes. Betty Litsua is also one of the managers at Linton's Beauty World, and she's been a makeup artist for a million years, as you can see.
And she actually has a fantasy makeup going yes. on her face.
And on this side, we have Svanhildr. Mm-hmm. Svanhildr is from Iceland. She's all the way from Iceland.
Ah.
Yes, and she's had a lot of makeup experience. She's also had an opportunity to work with the Game of Thrones.
No way.
Mm-hmm.
Really? We've got Sarah here, who's ready to get her face mm-hmm. turned into something. Do you even have an idea what she will do to your face? Okay, and we've got Ivy here. Betty, I just have to wait as well? Okay, no problem. And we've got Shireen.
Yes.
And Shireen, you told us you're gonna do the mermaid. So I'm gonna let you guys get into it. And
yes.
then I'll be popping in once in a while to just see.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Fantasy makeup is anything that is beyond the normal. Makeup that you use to create any image that you may have in your mind.
How long does it take?
This is going to take an hour and a half.
Wow, for one person though.
Yes. Because it might take shorter, but I want to manage your expectations and. Even if you want to come and do your regular makeup, mm-hmm. a full face of makeup mm-hmm. should take 1 hour.
So maybe a bit of introduction, what are Linton's? When did you get into Linton's and what do you do for Linton's?
I manage one of the Linton's beauty stores. I am very passionate about makeup and skincare. First of all, because when you have good skin, then everything else works out great. And then with makeup, you can rule the world, really. It boosts your confidence.
Yes, it does.
It does, right?
Totally agree.
Yeah, and you can create anything that you want to create. with makeup.
When I walked in here today, I was looking like an accident. But right now, I feel so good. I feel so good.
And you look amazing.
Totally.
When you come to a Linton store, there are people who have been trained. They're trained skincare specialists there. They're trained makeup artists. So they're going to look at your skin. They'll let you know what your skin type is. Although this is not to be confused with a dermatologist. There's a certain level where somebody really needs to see a dermatologist. Mm-hmm. But if you're looking to get the right skincare, if you've always wondered if you're using the right product, you know, is your skin dry and you're using product that makes it drier? Mm-hmm. And also makeup. Makeup goes with skin types. Yeah, there is a type of makeup that if you put and it's not going with your skin type, you might end up looking flaky. The situation can be a disaster.
Too dry, perhaps.
Exactly.
Yeah.
What Linton's does is give you quality makeup, quality skincare. When I say quality, I mean brands. Reputable brands, internationally recognized brands. We are starting a Linton's Beauty Academy, which I'm going to be one of the trainers for. So I'm going to be training and sharing my passion for makeup and skincare.
Wow, this is interesting. Mm-hmm. What's going on there?
So I was creating the base. Now we're going to start to create the scale looking things.
So how you, what is that?
So I need you to hold this fishnet.
Okay. So what do? I just keep holding like that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I'm just pulling it. Are you okay?
Are you okay with breathing?
Also going to be holding one day workshops for ladies such as yourself who wants to learn how to do your own makeup, not necessarily become a makeup artist. So we'll have all these programs running. Actually, we are at the academy right now. This is Linton's Beauty Academy, and we are going to be training on creative makeup as well, what we're showing here today, basic makeup, advanced makeup, bridal makeup. We're also going to be training on skincare, basic and advanced skincare, because definitely skincare is a major, major need in this our society, in this society of ours. Okay.
So your face, you did this to yourself.
Yes,
how
I did.
How long did it take?
It took 30 minutes. I wished I had more time, but
why would
I
didn't. 30 minutes?
Of course, I did my brows. I mean, I can't leave the house without doing my brows ever. And then I mixed a couple of colors there on my eyes to get that eyeshadow look. And then I definitely, of course, I did foundation. And then after foundation, I did the under eye. Now this is where everything goes down. So you go with a lighter concealer than your regular foundation color to bring out the under eye, to make it pop, to open up the under eye.
Would you walk around with, you know, like that kind of makeup on your face?
Well, I would, and I have. A lot of people would find it odd, mm-hmm. but for me, it's an expression of my artistry, so I absolutely would.
See how that looks? Whoa, that is good. And we've not seen anything yet. Can you see this outside?
I really like the nose.
Yeah,
the nose
I love
is
it.
Coming on well.
Yeah, that looks good.
You know, you asked me what are the makeup must-haves, but yeah. I'm very passionate about skincare, mm-hmm. and every makeup artist should be, because first you must have a good canvas to work with. So I'm talking things like exfoliating once a week, because every week your skin regenerates. Yeah, so you want to get rid of dead skin and reveal the youthful skin that's underneath. Mm-hmm. And then moisturize. Now here's where a lot of people go wrong. They don't put any moisturizer, but they go ahead and put foundation on their face.
Oh, you moisturize fast?
Yes. Okay. So now when you don't
I'm taking notes.
Yes, when you don't moisturize, your skin sucks up the foundation, the liquid of the foundation, because it's looking for moisture.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Right. And then we can use different kinds of primers. A lot of times people ask me, which primer should I use? It depends on your skin. If you have oily skin, you might want to use a mattifying primer. If you have dry skin, you might want to use a hydrating primer, you know, something that's going to bring more moisture.
So how much would it be to get like a fantasy look or that mermaid, or and comparing that to, you know, basic, ordinary, probably a wedding makeup? What's the full package?
Okay, so for a fantasy look, you're talking about, this is an advanced look and not every other makeup artist can do. So you're talking about anywhere from 10,000 shillings, yeah? And for a regular makeup look, I know there are many different makeup artists that charge differently, but I think a fair price is 5,000. 5,000 shillings, considering the person is using branded products, you know, so one of the major brands, and you know, then you know that they're observing hygiene and things like that. They're professional in what they do. One of the most important brushes you can ever have is this one. This is the one that does your brows. Remember I told you, brows are everything?
Yes.
Yes.
So what do I do with that?
Oh, with this one, mm-hmm. you would place it right there with the concealer mm-hmm. and move it along.
Okay.
And it would do just a perfect job of highlighting and shaping your brows.
Oh, okay.
So you don't have to spend every 2 weeks going to get your brows tweezed.
Oh,
yeah, because you can literally conceal out any brows, any brow hairs that are there.
So you're holding that, is it a thing? Like, I've been taught how to do that.
it just comes.
Well, I hope you guys had an amazing amazing time. This, we saw them before, and we've definitely seen the kind of creativity that can be put onto makeup, and this is what we call fantasy makeup. I hope you had a great time. So remember, if you want to learn how to do this, or even basic makeup like myself, it's very, very easy. You need to go online, follow them on Instagram at Linton's Beauty World, and same as Facebook, get to find out how you can join in and learn this amazing skills. This has been Creative of the Week. It's been beautiful. Keep this conversation going on our social media platforms. We love you guys. We're taking a very short commercial break, but we'll be right back with Spoken Arts.
Sina sikio wala sioni na hata kuhisi staki kwako mpenzi, nimetulia tuli mpaka utulivu unahoji. Kulikoni kwako mpenzi, nimejaa hadi ujazo unahoji. Kulikoni
silaha zote tuziweke chini, panga na hata spia, maana simba kwa flag washashika mikuki. Nimekuja ku spread love, I guess why zanita Cupid. Love one another, Zaidi Alucius na Cook.
Ay, ay, ay!